tudo.
How y'all doing? Homework video number 12. This is gonna be our knee relief sequence. But first we're gonna start out with a dynamic warm-up. So let's get into it. We're gonna start out in a tabletop. Turn this down. So for right now, all of this warm up, we're gonna hold each breath, each pose for 3 breaths. Right now, I want us to begin in tabletop. I feel like y'all can't really see me. Okay. And we're just gonna breathe in through the nose here. Breathe in. Imagine breathing in white light or gold light, and then breathe out through the mouth. Breathe out all the darkness. And breathe in through the nose. Breathe in the light. Breathe one more time out through the mouth. Breathe out the darkness. All the negativity that you had before you got on the mat. Gonna start fresh here. Now we're gonna start with a new breath. Our new breath on our yoga mat. Positive and filled with light, in through the nose and out through the nose. Fantastic. All right, we're gonna do some cat-cows here. So we're gonna look up and arch the back in. Cat-cow. And then you're gonna breathe in. Arch the back into cat. Breathe out. Exhale. Then breathe in. Start bend the back like a bridge. Breathe out. One more time, we're gonna breathe in. Arch the back like a cat. Then we're gonna breathe out like a cow. Good. And turn back to tabletop. Hold this here, 3 breaths. In through the nose, out through the nose. And just repeat that at your own pace. Now we're gonna do some bird dog. So kick up the right leg out. Kick the right leg out. And then bring the left arm forward. And you're gonna extend the foot. I want you to hold this here, 3 breaths. Now we're gonna do some crunches. So bring the elbow to your knee, bring the left elbow to the right knee, and then extend back out, bird dog, 1, breathe in, crunch, breathe out, 2, breathe in, crunch, breathe out, 3, keeping your core tight, breathe in, crunch, breathe out, 4, gonna do this one more time. Breathe in, crunch. Breathe out. Whew. Release back down to tabletop. And now I'm gonna do this on the other side. Okay. Go out into bird dog. Extend that left leg and right arm. 3 breaths here. In through the nose. Out through the nose. Then we're gonna crunch here. Bring that knee to the opposing elbow. Extend out. One. Breathe in, crunch. Breathe out. Exhale. Breathe in, crunch. Breathe out, exhale. Three. Two more times. Breathe in, crunch. Breathe out, exhale. Four. One more time. Breathe in, crunch. Breathe out. Five. Return to tabletop. And then push back. Well, don't go on the tabletop. Just push back into child's pose. So bring the knees out to the edge of the mat. And then push the arms out while you sit back on your feet. Push the arms out in front of you. And rest your head down on a block if you have it. I don't have blocks, but I have pillows. And if you have a blanket, that's acceptable too. I don't really like to use the props. Well, I don't have props, but if I did have props, I probably wouldn't use them much, but I'm gonna use this little arm thing here just to remind me to demonstrate props to you all. So right here, we'll be laying our head down on our block or whatever you have. Three breaths here. Good. Now push forward, push your shoulders a little bit above your wrists, and push your chest down, chaturanga down, and then push up into high cobra. So our pelvis and our thighs are still going to be on the ground, but our chest is going to be out. Our shoulders are going to be dropped away from our ears. Our feet just extended out flat. Good. Now we're going to push back into child's pose. Kick the knees out to the edge of the mat. Bring the big toes together and sit down on the heels of the feet. Extend the arms out and drop your head. Push up, bring the knees together, bend down, chaturanga down, and then rest the feet down, extended, push up at the waist, keeping the pelvis bone down again, and just having the stomach off, pushing yourself all the way up, chest up. Shoulders away from the ear. Three breaths here. Good. Push back, push up. It's an easy seat. So that's just sitting crisscross applesauce. We all know it. Okay, right here we're gonna do an easy seat over overhead stretch. So I gotta reach all the way up towards the ceiling. Try to touch the ceiling. Close the fingers up together. Three breaths here. Okay, drop the right arm down to the ground, or right elbow down to the ground rather, and then bring the left arm over the head, getting a nice stretch on the left side, keeping the hip all the way down on the ground. Three breaths here. And if you have a block or anything, you can always put the block down on the side, but you can rest on that. Rest your elbow on that. The short ways. All right, now we're gonna reverse it to the other side. Resting that arm down, then right arm overhead, getting a nice stretch on the right side. Nice. Now we're gonna come up and just rest here in easy seat. Rest your hands on your knees. Close your eyes, breathe in through your nose, out through your nose. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth here. That was a good warm-up. Breathe in through your nose again, out through your mouth. And this last time, breathe in through your nose and out through your nose. Beautiful. That is cool. Now we're gonna get into it. To curl the toes underneath, inhale up, downward dog. So here, we're gonna try to hold all of our breaths a good 6 breaths total. All of our poses, I mean, a good 6 breaths total. So anyways, I want us to practice our form, have your palms flat down, fingers spread wide to have a good plant down. Try to touch your heels to the ground, but if they can't, that's fine. Mine can't touch. It's okay. And we're going to try to make our triceps touch our ears. Going to try to make your hamstrings come in towards the center of your body. Going to be looking at your belly button. Slight bend in the knees. You like, you can walk this out. Fantastic. You're going to put a slight bend in the knee and kick your right foot forward. And we're going to push up. Use your right knee to push up if you need to. Plant that back left foot all the way down. Turn it at a 90 degree angle. Keep the front leg bent and your feet facing forward. I'm gonna kick my left foot back some more to get a good lunge in the front right leg. I'm gonna put my arms out, one in front of me, one directly behind me. I'm gonna look over the front arm, warrior two. 6 breaths here. In through the nose, out through the nose. In through the nose, out through the nose. Fingertips straight out, reaching out long, trying to touch each wall. Good. Now I want you to inhale here and then exhale your arm down to the ground. Straighten that front right leg. I want you to straighten the hand flat down on the ground. If you have blocks or anything like that, you can put your block up long ways and bring the ground closer to you, okay? We're gonna be here. Our feet is still gonna be the same way. Back foot, the foot's gonna be facing, it's gonna be parallel with the back of the mat, and then our front foot's gonna be facing forward. So as we're gonna be our left arm's gonna go directly up in the sky. We're gonna open our chest out, bringing our shoulder away from our ear. Oh. And triangle pose. at the waist. Use your core to help you come up slowly. And then bring both feet to like a 90 degree angle. And take a seat, sit down. Well, like still standing, but like bend down all the way. Bend down as much as you can, taking a seat down. And then bend your arms up. Spreading the fingers out. Making sure the back is straight. Goddess pose. Six breaths here. Good. Now, you're gonna spread the feet out a little bit more and come down. Well, I'm gonna actually just keep my legs closer. Come down into garland pose. So, hold on, let's get back into it. So if I'm in goddess, I'm gonna bring my feet in some, but still bent. Bring my hands to prayer, and then slowly start to sit down all the way, bringing my elbows to my thighs. Almost, or to my knee, a thigh, whatever you want to call it. Back straight, chest out, shoulders back, looking straight up. Six breaths here. Good, now stay bent down. Bring your hands down to the mat and then bring them over to the right side of you and pivot to the right side. Pivot to the right side. Bring your elbows down to the ground. Forearms flat down on the ground. Still having your right leg bent up. Bring the left leg out. And push up. So you're going to be on your left toes in lizard. Six breaths here. On lizard, you would have your block, your two blocks under your two forearms. So, and bringing the ground closer up to you. Okay, good. Now we're gonna push up. Push up. Bring that bent right leg, push it out straight, and then flex the foot. You're gonna do a half split. Gonna be in your fingertips here. You need to, you can kind of sit back into this position to get more of a stretch in the front right leg. You have both of your blocks underneath your hands again, bringing the ground closer to you, or your pillows or blankets, whatever you have. Six breaths here. Good. Gonna do it again on the other side now. Get back in tabletop. Curl the toes under. Take a deep breath in. And push up. Back into an upward facing dog. Six breaths here. Remember your form. Shot and make it better. Bend the knees, slightly bend the knees, and kick out the left leg. We're going to do warrior two on the other side. Bring that back leg to parallel. Let me bring that back foot to parallel with the back of the mat. Have your toes facing your left leg toes facing the front of the mat. I'm going to bring myself into a deeper lunge. Bring my arms out, one directly in front of me, one behind me. Trying to reach each wall. Gazing over my left hand. Six breaths total here. Good, now straighten that front right leg. Drop the left arm flat, the left hand flat down. Keeping the feet the same direction they already are. I'm gonna bring in my left foot some. Then I'm gonna reach all the way up towards the sky with my right arm, looking straight up. Straight forward, triangle. Good. All right, from triangle, I want you to come push up at the waist and make both feet both at a 90 degree angle, so both feet, both toes should be pointing towards the edge of the mat. We're gonna bend, bring our hands straight up towards the sky, and then bend our elbows, making a 90 degree angle with our arms, and then bend our legs down, making a 90 degree with our knees and our legs. Goddess pose, looking straight forward, shoulders dropped away from the ear. Good, now I'm gonna bring my feet in a little bit closer together. Bring my hands into prayer position, and I'm gonna squat down so my arms reach my knees or my thighs. My bottom's not gonna be touching the ground. If I have a block, I can put the block underneath my bottom and sit on it. Not the long ways up, the short ways. Six breaths here. Really using those knees to hold your elbows up so you can keep the chest out. Good. Now we're going to call the hands over to the right side of the mat. Going to kick the left leg out as if we're going into a low lunge, and then we're going to drop the forearms down to the ground. We're going to hold this lizard for six breaths. You can have both blocks, remember, under each forearm if you need. Okay, good. Drop the knee. Oh no, don't drop the knee. We're gonna go into half split. So while you're here in lizard, I want you to push up on your hands and then come up on your back left knee, keeping your front right leg bent and then extending that front right leg and then flexing the foot in front of you. Having your fingertips planted on the ground to keep you planted. If you want more of a stretch in the front right leg, I would just sit the bottom back towards the feet. Six breaths here total. Okay. Good. Now we're gonna meet in butterfly. So we're gonna come into a seat on our bottom, and then we're gonna bring both of our feet together. Bring both of our feet together. Let your legs flop down on the side of you. And if you have any blocks, you can put blocks underneath your knees if your knees go to the ground. Or if your knees can rest on the blocks, you can put them there. Straight back. And then we're going to walk the hands forward. Trying to drop the head down to the feet. I cannot, but I'm going to go as far as I can. My head's going to go as far as it can towards my feet. With each breath, I feel like I can go a little bit deeper, so I do. On this breath, I'm going to push back up slowly. Good. Now I want you to lay down on your back. Notes here. Alright, so we're gonna do a wind relieving. So you gotta you are going to extend both of your feet and your legs and your feet out, let your feet flop towards the side. And then you're going to bring your right leg, your right knee to your chest. You gotta hug that knee and love on yourself. Flex your left foot. Hold this here, 6 breaths. Breathing in through the nose, out. In through the nose, out. Okay, and then you're gonna switch legs. Six breaths here. Good. Now we're gonna do reclined pigeon. So bend the right leg. And then bring the left leg to a bend. Bring the left ankle over the right knee. And then bring the right knee to your chest. Hug the right thigh. And breathe in here, 6 breaths. Slowly drop that knee down, unwind, and then on the other side, bring that right ankle over the left knee, bring the left knee to your chest, hug your left thigh, 6 breaths here. Remember to flex that, I said on the other side, but flex that foot, that left foot. You're gonna want to slowly drop the legs down. And do a
supine twist. Bring, while both the legs are down, you're gonna bring the right foot and plant it on, down flat on the left side of your right leg. And then you're going to do a spinal twist. You're gonna twist that leg all the way down. And you're gonna look the opposite way. With your hand, you can be using your left arm to hold your leg over, and then you can hold your right arm out, looking right as well. Slowly help, use that hand to help you bring that leg up, and then you gotta switch sides, straighten the right leg, bring the left leg over, and twist on the left side. Use your right arm to help you bring the left leg down. Looking on the left side. Anything on your back as well. With the blocks, you can have it under your lower back. Use it as like a cushion or a bolster for your lower back. So any of those previous poses I didn't say before, like pigeon and wind relieving, you can have the block underneath your lower back, by the way. So like right now, we're about to go into happy baby. So you know, when the baby's happy, they grab their two little big toes. So we're gonna grab both of our, breathe in and bring your legs up to your chest. Grab both your big toes and then kick up like your happy baby, and then twist and rock, rock back and forth. Six breaths here. Felt good on my lower back, kind of rolling around like that. All right, stretch the legs out all the way down. We're gonna do recline big toe. So those who have like a strap or something like that, you would take the strap on the bottom of your foot, and you would kick up all the way to the sky and have that strap help you keep the foot extended back. But for the rest of us, we're gonna do a happy baby only on the right side. Grab the right big toe with the two fingers, and then kick all the way up to the sky. It's okay if your leg is a little bent, that's fine. Make sure your hips are fully on the ground. Both shoulders are fully on the ground. Well, one might be a little off the ground, the right side, but make sure your hips are still on the ground. Kick out as hard as you can. All right, and then relax that arm back down to the side. Slowly relax the leg down, keeping the foot flexed. Twisting back down. You're gonna do it on the left side as well. Grab the big toes and then kick up. Kind of shifting your leg to the left, to the right side. Keeping that tailbone down on the ground. Alright, good. Release your arm back down. Release the leg down slowly.
And then, corpse pose, savasana, keep the legs out, let the feet flop to the side, bring your arms down towards the feet, and close your eyes. Gonna rest here for 6 breaths, breathing in through the nose, out through the nose. Good. Now we're going to get back into it one more time. So from Savasana, you're going to twist to a side and get into fetal position. And whatever arm is in front of you, I want you to push up slowly. The head is going to be the last thing to rise. Put another kick, sit down, then push back into tabletop. Curl the toes underneath. And then we're going to breathe in to downward facing dog. Remembering our form, palms flat, fingertips open, heels trying to touch the ground, walk it out if you need to, triceps and hamstrings coming towards the center of the body, looking at your belly button. Slightly bend the knees. And kick the right leg through. Warrior two. Planting that back foot firmly all the way down, making it 90 degrees. Last warrior two on this side, so really get a nice stretch in there. Dropping the shoulders away from the ear. Good, now straighten that front leg. Drop the front right arm down. Plant the palm flat down. Extend the left arm all the way up towards the sky. Fingertips trying to touch the sky. Looking straight forward. Triangle. Good. Now we're going to walk the hand, drop the left hand down, walk the hand in front of you. Gonna be bent at the waist. And then I want you to bend the knees, make the feet go 90 degrees. Push up at the waist till you have a straight back, knees still bent. Reach the arms up straight. Try to touch the ceiling and then bend them at the elbow, creating a 90 degree angle with the arms, goddess pose. Breathing in through the nose, out through the nose here, 6 breaths. Good, now we're gonna go into garland. Bring the legs in some, feet still facing the same direction. Bring the palms in to prayer. And then squat all the way down till your elbows reach your knees. And sit down into it, but don't sit down completely. Making sure the feet are completely flat. They're not, then kick the legs out some more. Using your knees to open the chest. Looking up, 6 reps here. Good.
Now drop the hands down. Walk them over to the right. Go into a low, like your, keep the right leg bent. And then kick the left leg out and do a low lunge and drop the forearms down to lizard. Six breaths here. Chest out, looking straight ahead. Plant the hands down, push up, drop that back knee down, straighten the front leg, and flex the front foot. Half split here. Remember to use your block if you need to. Block could be under your hands right now. Half split. Six breaths. Good. Now kick that right foot behind you. Curl that right toe under. And the left curl. Left. Curl the left toe under and then push up, downward dog. Hold six breaths here. Remember your form, looking at your belly button. Fingertips spread. Slightly bend the knees. Kick the left leg through. Last warrior two of this class, of this session, so let's really commit to it. Really lunge in. Six breaths here. Good, now we're going to straighten that front leg. Go into triangle. Good. Drop both hands down. Walk them in front of you. Make both feet go out to a 90-degree angle. Bend the knees. Push up at the waist. Reach the arms up towards the ceiling. And then bend them down, 90-degree angle. Goddess pose. Straight back. Okay, now I'm gonna walk my legs in some. Whew, I need to straighten out a little bit, sorry. My legs in some. Bring my hands to heart prayer, to heart center in prayer. And then bend down to garland. Sit down into it. Flat feet. If feet aren't flat, kick out some more. Use your knees to push your elbows into to open the chest out. All right, plant the arms down. Walk the hands over to your left side. We're going to get into lizard. Whew. Front left foot is flat down. Forearms down. Right leg lunge back. Good. Drop that right knee down. Push up. Straighten the left front leg. Have the fingertips planted down. Or you can have the blocks underneath your hands here. Gonna do half split.
kind of sit back down into it to get more of a stretch in that front left leg. Flex the front foot.
Back straight. Mm-hmm. I know I'm probably hunching.
Good. Now we're gonna come into butterfly. We're almost done. Remember, both feet touching. Let the knees fall down to the flat out to the side. If you want, you can have your blocks underneath your knees. Reach out. Try to do your touch your head to your knees. To your feet.
Six breaths here.
Good. Lock the hands up. We're gonna lay down on the back.
Bring your right knee to chest. Hug your right knee. Breathing in through the nose and out through the nose here. Six breaths total. And kick out. Extend that leg out. On the left side, bring the knee to chest. And have your block underneath you here, and on your lower back. Kick out. Now we're gonna do half pigeon. Bend that right knee. Bring your left ankle over your right knee. Bring your right knee to chest and hug your right thigh. Flex your right foot. Hold this here. Six breaths total. Drop the right leg and unwind. Now you're gonna do it on the opposite side. Cross that right leg over and bring that left knee to chest. Hug the left thigh. Flex the left foot. Gonna drop that foot and unwind. Recline spinal twist. Plant the right foot down on the left side. Use the left arm to help the left leg go down and look to the right. Making sure the head, your spine is still aligned all the way down. Your head and your leg are all straight. Look in the opposite direction and extend your arm in the opposite direction. And twist, and let's go on the opposite side. Cool, now meet back
Straighten your body back to center. Ooh. And happy baby. Grab both big toes. Bring the knees to your chest. Six breaths here. Okay. Now I would keep holding on to that right foot and extend it up and then kick out the left foot slowly all the way down. Left arm all the way down planted. Remember, if you have a strap, you can use your strap here. Recline big toe. Unhook that big toe and slowly drop the leg down, keeping the foot flexed. Okay, now we're gonna grab the left side big toe or use your strap and do a climb big toe, keeping the right arm extended out so it can help our right leg stay down. Unhook. Slowly drop that leg, keeping the foot flexed. And now Savasana, corpse pose. We made it through. Yay for us, right? I want you to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. Again, breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. Breathe in through the nose. And out to the mouth. Love you.
Love you too.
And through the nose. Out through the nose. Imagining that you're filling up with positivity and light when you breathe in. And when you breathe out, you breathe out the darkness and negativity. And each time you breathe in, more and more space fills up with light. And pretty soon, all the darkness is booted out. All the light filled up the space. Feels really beautiful. I want you to know this is the feeling of being able to feel like you can do anything. Are you tired? Maybe. But don't you feel like you are light? And floating. Life is gonna sometimes make you tired. But we did yoga. We found an exercise to teach us when we get tired, what do? We breathe through it. We get disciplined. We focus. we implement actions, and then we'll feel accomplished. Once it's done, you can rest. Like now, we're resting. We got through it. Thank you, God. Thank you, universe. Thank you, all those around me, all those tuned in, all those engaged. I shed light to you. Say thank you to your knees. They help us live alive. Help us dance, help us walk, help us move. Get in the right positions for what we need to be in, the right positions for, you know. Help us stay stable. So I just wanted to show some appreciation to the knees, say thank you to it, give some relief, some stretching out. We get distracted here. I want you to just focus back in on the breath. Maybe count the breaths in your head. You know, like someone's trying to go to sleep, they count sheep. Your breaths can be whatever you want them to be. They can be sheep. Be apples, they can be whatever. Just count them. Money, breathe in the dollars. Now keep breathing in that light. Can't let the darkness back in. Keep it out, keep it out. At this point, we're breathing out clear.
And you say you need more than a friend.
Start bringing awareness to the body, wiggling the toes and the fingers, maybe twirling the ankles and the wrists. And whenever you're ready, turn over to whatever side and whatever hand's in front of you, slowly push up. The head's going to be the last thing to come up. Thank you. Much love. Hands to heart center. Let's take a bow. The light in me sees the light in you. Namaste.